we did before the gematria of or the four character of Mashiach with the name Ekiye, with the number 1020. Right? We did that this equal Avraham, Yitzchak, Yaakov, Esav, and this equal Cohen, Levi, Yisrael, Mashiach. And this parallel equal two time Nahar. The four time the river. It means each one of them is represented by one of the four rivers that are in the creation of the world. And in the book of the Revelation, he mentioned the Prat. We know that the Prat is in the place of the wisdom from the book of Revelation. So we have the order of the four river in the book of Revelation, but we didn't did yet the gematria of the four river together. The first one is Pishon, after Gihon, after Chidekel.
Pishon and Prat.
And after Prat, the four rivers. We didn't do yet the gematria of this four river. How much equal this four river together? 1345. What it's like 1000 plus Moses. Moses with the 1000 light. And equal Keter Kol Aktarim, the crown of all crown. Keter Kol Aktarim. So here we have Moses plus 1000. 1000, it's like the end of the day, it's the 1000 light, it's Mashiach ben Yosef plus Mashiach ben David, etc. What else equals this number? What we talk about all the time? Flying. Snake, flying snake. Saraf Mofef. Saraf Mofef. No, Saraf Mofef equal 856, what is four times Ruach. It's like we have four spirit. We say that this equal two times two time Menachem, this equal two times Miriam, etc. So we have two spirit in both sides, the two four. Four times spirit. But if I write these two words in filling letter, this would be Shin, Resh, Pei. This equal 951. Now we take Mofef in filling letter. Mem, Ein, Vav, Pei, Pei. This equal 394. How much is together? 1345. Flying snakes.
Snake.
Okay, so now, like we did with the other concept, we write them in symmetry. So, So we will have the prat in the middle, in the place of the wisdom, we have the prat. We have the chidekel. We have the chidekel. We have the gichon. We have the gichon. And we have here the pishon. And here we have the pishon. Write it in symmetry, 7 words. How much equal together? 2010. This of course remind us the number 21 I shall be. We have 10 times the Aleph and we have 20 times and we have 100 times the Hey Vav Hey, the Hey Yud Hey, the rest of the name. 10 times the Aleph and 100 times the Heye. The three other letters. Together equal 10 times 201. What is 201? 201 is emtza, middle. The middle of the symmetry. What else equals the middle? What is the middle point between Aleph and Taf? The beginning end of the Aleph Bet and the end of the Aleph Bet. I am the Aleph and I am the Taf, like said Jesus. I am the beginning and I am the end. What is the middle point?
Alpha and Omega, it was translated in Greek. Yeah.
This equals 401. What is the middle point of these two letters, between these two letters?
401 plus 1
split to 2 equals 201, the middle. So I put all the four rivers in a symmetrical way and I receive a number that has to do with the name Ekye, 21, the same digit, and the concept of the middle, of the symmetry. If I wrote Saraf Mofef with a big pay equal 800 instead of 80, you know, the Mantzapach. So then I receive in the Gimetia. So then the average value of these two words will be 2 times 574. The number what we saw before. Good, good, evil, evil, etc. Alright, so I think it's enough for today. Or something I forget about to Uziyahu.
Ah, by the way, before we go, is there Saraf that is not Meofef, or always Saraf Meofef?
No. Saraf is a snake.
Snake.
Did you ever saw a snake that fly?
No.
It's two opposite things, a snake that fly. A snake even cannot walk. You want him to fly. He's completely attached to the ground. It's the most paradox that you can think about. Mm-hmm. If he's a snake, how can he fly? Even cannot walk, you want him to fly.
Mm-hmm. So
this was the idea. It's a flying snake. It is another verse in Eov, if I'm not wrong. Uvnei reshef yagbiu uf. It's the same letter of Saraf. Son of Reshafim. Reshafim, it's like angels of fire. They will fly high, very high. The same letter, equal 10 times Chen, like Saraf, Reshef.
But the Saraf shows in the Bible just Saraf?
Well, the Saraf bite the people in the desert, and then Moses built the
because there's Nahash and this
there are many names for snakes in Hebrew.
Snakes, yeah.
Right? Is Nahash, is a Shifon, is a Tsefa, is a and is Saraf, and there is Piton. There are many names.
They show up in the Torah.
There are many names of snakes.
So it shows up in the Torah also in a separate context, just as Saraf?
Yes, yes, Asrafim in the story of the, in the desert, the Asrafim bite the people. Mm-hmm. So then Moses built the snake on his nest. And then everybody that used to look on the snake of Moses, he used to be healed from the snake. Okay, so the snake, in one way, he kill you, in another way, he heal you. Mm-hmm. Depend if you really look in, on what snake you really put your eyes. A good snake or a bad snake. Or maybe you even don't want to look the snake. You don't want to understand what is the snake. For you, the snake is a devil. This snake is going to bite you. Because this is exactly what you think he is. Mm-hmm. Right? Okay. So if you think the snake is a devil, so this devil is going to bite you one day. Mm-hmm. Right? Like he bite everybody.
So your imagination is your reality.
In the age of 120, everybody is bite by the snake. Everybody died in this world. Right, but if we understand this snake good enough, we can make this snake fly. This snake that is inside of us, we can make it light, fly. And this is a fruit.
That's the metaphor, it's a symbol.
This is a fruit of the root of Yishai that calls snake.